You've been given this vaccine, even though it still remains in phase three trials. And I'm curious, why did you feel comfortable taking it?
You mean me personally?
Yes.
Me personally. When or why?
Why?
Why? Two reasons. Main reason, I'm responsible for the production. And better to test on myself before we will give it for the production. It's the first thing. The second thing, I have a lot of meetings with the people, and to be 100% sure that you will not be infected, you cannot be on a safe side. So for both, for the people and for myself, not to flip up from the business scale and from the from my schedule, because there are two options actually: either you're vaccinated, or the big percentage of infection.
Are you not worried though about repercussions, given the fact that it's still in trials?
You know, our school of epidemiology in general are quite tough, and this vaccine is based on well-known platform. It's a human adenovirus. And if you will compare with some other vaccines which might be on the market, at least what I heard, based on a monkey adenovirus. So I prefer the human adenovirus. And this platform, well known, and actually all the formula is open, and all the specialists can get the clear picture which confirms that there are no obstacles, except the first maybe few days. Myself, I feel some fever in the evening, maybe a few hours. The next day, slightly headache, because your body using a lot of glucose. Mm. So in this case, it's just the feelings. But the second shot on the 22nd day, I didn't feel anything. And for example, my son, he didn't feel even the first shot.
Oh, wow. So you had your whole family vaccinated?
No, not the whole family. My son decided, because I'm not insisting anyone to take such a decision.
So some Western trials have had to stop.
My mother, for example, she's also vaccinated. She's 84.
Oh, okay. So some Western trials, as I'm sure you know, have had to stop due to adverse effects. Do you think the Russian vaccine is somehow safer?
You know, better not to go on the level of discussion who is better, who is worse. We can say that Russia has got the vaccine, which I already mentioned you, based on the human adenovirus, and as well as the second vaccine we will receive very soon, called Vector. So at least we will have two vaccines at the same time, and the main task for us is to zoom, to scale up the production. I would say, when you produce in a small quantity, like 50 kilos, and the laboratory, the Institute of Gamaleya, they started from 20 kilos. They scale up to 50, And the main task is to scale up to 1 ton reactor. So today, this is the most difficult issue to get the same quality of the stability of vaccine on 20 and 50 kilo to 100, 500 and 1,000 kilo reactors. This is the main task for us.
I'm going to ask you more about the production of it, but I did first want to also ask you if President Vladimir Putin has received the vaccine.
I've been aware, maybe not yet, but he's under decision.
But you still think he's arguably, as many would say, probably the most important man in Russia. Do you think the vaccine is safe enough for him to take it?
It's definitely safe enough. It's the thing of, is I give an example from my family. I know that, and everybody knows that the daughter of the president vaccinated. But it's think when and which and how to make it. That's it.
How many doses have so far been produced of the vaccine in Russia?
Altogether, this month we will come more than 40,000 doses.
And what is 20,000? So what is stopping Russia right now from getting it?
40,000.
30,000. So what is stopping Russia right now from getting into the millions?
As I mentioned to you, the first thing, we are completing the third phase. And the second issue is we have to scale up the production facilities. We are getting ready to do it, but we need some gap of the time, because by next month we are planning to reach the quantity coming to 800,000 doses. By the end of the year, about 1.5 million. And starting from January, February, we need to zoom up to 3 and 15 million a month. This is the target which we need to reach.
Because we also heard that Russia is aiming to manufacture as much as 30 million by the end of the year. Do you no longer think that's realistic?
30 million a month by the end of next year?
End of this year.
End of this year? No, it's impossible. Frankly speaking, it's impossible. If somebody will say such information, I mean, it's nonsense. I'm giving you the absolutely adequate information.